So I've got a crazy video for you guys today. This is very unorthodox. I don't do creepypastas or anything, so I don't expect anything like this ever again. But they're actually making a movie about some shit that went down in the 70s in my area. A local legend that I knew about as a teenager. Everybody around here knew about it. You guys know what I'm talking about. Every town has that urban legend. The guy with the hook that preys on the teenagers that are making out in the car. That kind of shit. But this really happened, and this man is in prison to this day. He's in his 70s. He comes up for parole every couple of years. Of course, he's denied. What happened is he hooked this girl to the back of his car or his truck and dragged her and killed her, basically. He dragged her all the way up to this place called Starr Hill and buried her in a shallow grave. The police found her after a farmer reported seeing some shit. I think it was debris on the road, reported it, and they put two and two together. The police had suspected this guy of previous issues before, and it's suspected that he has committed multiple murders. They haven't been able to prove it, but they're pretty certain that he did commit more than one. So, this happened when my parents were teenagers, and this is something that just completely rocked the town of Steuben in the Rome area up here in central New York. This kind of shit just doesn't happen up here, guys. I'm talking about, I live in Cowtown, okay? This kind of shit, it just rocked everybody. So over the years, things have kind of been twisted. Starr Hill has become very mysterious anyways. There's a lot of legends. There's one about a chair up there, a rocking chair. If you sit in it, you'll mysteriously die. Some days later, there's one actually about a lantern. I'm going to talk to you guys about that towards the end of the video because that is the most interesting part, in my opinion, because I have a personal experience with it. But this guy did this terrible shit. And as you know, Hollywood likes to take a look at those things and then kind of play off of them. They're not going by this man's name. They're not going by the details. But just for accuracy's sake, his name is Bernard Hatch. But they're going to kind of spin it, kind of like how the Leatherface thing was spun out of some other guy. I can't remember who it was. Somebody that used some sort of cutting saw or something that really happened. A lot of these movies do that. They'll take a local legend and they'll kind of twist it. They don't want to obviously offend anyone because this is something that still they're surviving family members to this day, and it's kind of a sensitive thing, you could imagine. But they actually started casting not too long ago in my area to be in this. I don't know if the movie's going to be any good. I mean, let's be honest, usually these movies are terrible. It's something that goes like direct to Netflix or some shit like that. I'm going to watch it though because, I mean, this is, it's my local history. It's something that we always told spooky stories about. And I actually went up there with my cousin Jerry, who passed away. I talk about him often when I reference SOCOM here on the channel. I went up there with him and my friend Andy and Paul. And it was foggy out, and going up the hill, the fog just all of a sudden hit the car. And I remember going, oh shit, and we were partying. I was probably drunk and stoned. And so when that happened, I was like, oh my, and I remember like raising up out of my seat because it just took me by surprise. And my cousin was like, damn, chill, you calm down. And I felt like an idiot because I just kind of blew up my spot, as we called it back in the day. We start going up over the hill, and it's just this thick fog, and off to the side I remember seeing a fire, some guy with a really long trench coat standing there. So it was really ominous just going up there. I remember thinking, what are these people doing, like partying up here? So fucking freaky, why would you even want to hang out up here? But at any rate, we rolled up the hill and we found this nice little lookout, and truth be told, I think we fired up a blunt. I think that's why we were up there. That's the kind of shit that we did. It was spooky. And it's just spur of the moment kind of thing. Hey, let's just go up to Starr Hill and fucking burn one. All right, sure. So we go up to this lookout and we're sitting there. And that, by the way, should not harm the credibility of my story. Just letting that be known. Smoking pot is not going to make you see shit, okay? Unless it's fucking laced, and then you got a problem. But no, anyway, we're sitting on the lookout and we're watching this field. And it's a pretty big field. It's hard to see the other side. It's hard to even see. I'd say probably about 15, 20 feet out is where visibility just really gets tough. So this light starts to cut through the fog, and it's bobbing like someone's carrying it, okay? And it's flickering like a lantern would. And, you know, what the fuck is that? It's at first when you see it, it's just this light. Then you start to make out the details. It's flickering. It's bobbing. I'm like, that's a fucking lantern. Somebody's walking down there with a lantern. Who the hell would be up here? It was like 11 o'clock at night on a school night. Okay, and the only reason why I remember it was a school night is because I talked to my cousin about it, Graceland, on the bus the next day. And that's where the plot thickens. So we see this fucking lantern, and it starts coming closer to us. When it got about 30 feet or so away, we got the fuck out of there. We're like, yeah, let's get out of here. This is weird. So we took off, and I get on the bus the next day, and I told my cousin Grace, yeah, I went up there with Jerry, and we just went up there to party a little bit. And she's like, oh yeah, did you see the doctor that walks around with a lantern that makes house calls? He died like during the Civil War or some shit like that. My jaw just hit the fucking ground. I was like, what? I said, we did see a fucking lantern up there. Yes, I swear to God, we saw a lantern. And she's like, really? I don't think she believed me, to be honest. I couldn't believe it, because it's one of those things where nobody knew. You know, she didn't know I'd seen it. I didn't know it was a thing. So when she told me it was a thing, it confirmed that it was a thing. It could have been some kid out in the field fucking around, but that late, that foggy, shitty weather on a school night, no, that doesn't make any sense. At that point is when I, because I've always been a very scientific person, okay, I always look to reason. At that point, that's when I started to think, okay, science, I don't think has all the fucking answers, because that was some shit. That was some really freaky shit, and to this day, I haven't been back up there. This is a story I haven't told in a long time, and something I haven't thought about in a long time, but when I saw them making this movie, I was like, oh shit. Now, they're not going to talk about that legend. They're going to talk about the actuality, because it's far more scary. This actually happened. This guy was pretty much a serial killer. They can't prove it, but they know that he killed more than one victim, several, according to the authorities. But, it's something that it reminds me of my cousin. It reminds me of just the good times, and it reminds me of the first time I really began to understand that I don't really have a grasp on everything in the universe. There's some shit that happens that you just don't, you can't really explain it. So there you have it, guys. A little creepy story for you from EQA Nostalgia. Let me know what you think of it. Now, there is an article on this, in case anybody thinks I'm just blowing smoke up their ass. You can check it out. I'm going to link it down in the description. If you guys enjoyed this video, please remember to leave a thumbs up. I thank you all for watching, and I look forward to seeing you all in my next video.